Hey everyone, I'm currently working on an all-white Mini ITX build, so when I seen Thermalright's Peerless Assassin 120 Mini White, I thought it could be completely perfect, because this has got a smaller clearance than some CPU coolers. For example, at 135mm height, that's actually smaller than something like the Noctua NHD15. I know that's a full tower cooler, but that's like 155mm, so you are going to get less clearance with this, and hopefully it'll fit in more Mini ITX cases. The box itself is all fairly standard, you know, just giving you the details it needs and showing you pictures of the actual item, which obviously we'll look at in just a minute. And then the actual back actually shows you a bit more specs. Annoyingly, Amazon stuck stickers everywhere, but I got some of them off. And basically, you know, it'll support all of the latest Intel and AMD sockets. That's absolutely fine. Gives you the dimensions there without a fan. And in general, some people say this clashes a little bit with really tall RAM sticks. Other people say it doesn't at all, but you know, that is something we'll look at later on in this video. And you've got the fan specs here as well. This supports obviously a full 120mm fan, which is quite nice actually, because you know, some Mini ITX cases and coolers, you are going to need to downgrade to a smaller fan, and that can be slightly noisier, but this particular one, just about see it if I actually get that sticker off. This particular one is meant to be a little bit quieter than other ones, so that is pretty good. And obviously the fan itself is 4-pin PWM, going into the CPU fan header, fluid dynamic bearing, all fairly standard. And we can unlock the force chill here. That's kind of cool, isn't it? But let's open it up. So this is actually what's inside the box. You've got this bit of cardboard that slides out. Oh, that's quite fancy. Oh, that's fancy. I quite like that. That is really fancy. So you've got that slides out. You've then got an accessories package, which we'll look at in a minute. And it does warn you there's sharp edges. Use extreme caution. So that's good to know. If we get some of this actual packaging out of the way, and this is actually really well packaged. I've had coolers before with very little packaging, and then you get like a bent fin or something. This is actually quite impressive considering this is more of a budget cooler. So yeah, let's just get that out of the way. Very good packaging, I must admit. Let's take that off. So that is the fan that goes in the middle. And obviously you can swap out the fan with another 120mm fan as well if you wanted. I might do that if this is too noisy, but hopefully it won't be too bad. Right, so this is the actual CPU cooler, as you can see there. So actually, you know, you've got your 6 heat pipes on either side. It's a double-sided cooler, so the 12 heat sinks there, which is good. Obviously got your little warning sticker, which some people always forget to remove when doing a build, but make sure you do remove it, obviously. And then just your 2 screws as normal to actually screw that into the motherboard. And yeah, it's quite a good layout. I was saying about bent fins, I've actually got bent fin there actually looking at it, but that's easy enough to bend back. But in general, yeah, it looks really, really nice. Everything is white. It's not like, you know, when you look at it closely, you start seeing bits of silver or something like that. The only silver really is with the actual bracket. Everything else is really nice and white. Same Thermalright, of course. It's just going to go in your case. And in a minute, I'll line it up against the motherboard just so we can look at the RAM clearance too. But this is the actual included fan as well. So you've got that there. It clips on with the clips that's in the accessories package, which we'll look at in a minute. But the actual fan itself is quite nice. Got quite a lot of blades as well, which is good. So hopefully it can move a decent amount of air while running a little bit, you know, quieter. So that's always quite good, you know, at lower RPMs. And it just clicks in there. And there's a decent amount of clearance as well. Like I've had some, you know, CPU coolers in the past where it's actually quite hard to get the fan in. This one clips on quite nicely. So we'll have a look at that in a second. But that is the actual CPU cooler and the fan. So you can see that there. And then we've got the accessory package as well. So let's just open that up. Move that out of the way slightly. So just put it on this side as well so we can see that a bit better. So this is what's in the accessories package, and obviously there is an instruction manual and all that, but in general you've got everything you're gonna need. So nice little blister pack. There is a lot in here. So if you've got an Intel, it does tell you anyway, but if you've got an Intel motherboard, you know, on like the 1200 socket or the 17XX socket, then, you know, this actually gives you what you need to know. And you can actually slide this particular bit in and out, which is pretty nice, to actually adjust accordingly to the particular socket. So you don't need to use a different bracket or screw or, you know, different spacers like you sometimes need. You can literally just move that particular bit, which is quite nice. So that's for Intel, and then you've got your standard, you know, fan clips, which you probably know how to do this anyway, but you know, you just clip that into the fan on either side. You do that on both sides, and then when you come to install it, you know, you're going to put that in the actual cooler itself. and just clip it onto the heatsink fins. You know, it's all fairly standard, but if you haven't done it before, I just wanted to show you. You would do that on both sides, obviously. I've only done it on one side just so I can more easily, you know, get it out. But that's how you would do that with the particular fan. So put that there and put the heatsink back there. And what else do you have? So in here then, you've got a bunch of other fixings. So that's gonna be for Intel, the actual standoffs for that. I'm gonna be doing an AM5 build, so I'll focus a bit more on that, but that is for Intel, you know, and you could just follow the instructions as well, it's easy enough. If you're doing an AM4 or AM5 build, you're gonna actually see that that's very clearly labeled. So that's absolutely fine. AM4, AM5, that's cool. And then in here, you've got yet another package, which comes with their own thermal paste as well. I tend to use Arctic or Noctuous thermal paste, but I've heard the Thermalright TF7 is fairly good. And then you've got your brackets, so AM4, but that is the actual heatsink. It's all fairly simple. This is more of an unboxing video. I'm not going to do a performance review of it in this particular video, but I'll do that in a separate video. But what I wanted to do now is actually look at the motherboard just so we can try and gauge the actual clearance and things like that. So I'm just going to go and get a motherboard. Okay, so I got the X870 Aorus Pro Ice as part of the white mini ITX build I'm working on. I'm not gonna fully mount things, but what I wanted to do was just see, you know, where the CPU cooler might line up for the purposes of RAM clearance and things like that. So let's take a look. But I'm not actually gonna mount it. I just wanted to roughly see where things would line up, so I could see whether there'd be any RAM clearance issues. And it's gonna line up in the middle there. And from what I can see, I think it would cause RAM clearance issues if you actually had a particularly large heatsink. I'll put other footage on the screen now because it's kind of hard to show it here. So here you can actually see it closer up, all mounted up, and I've used digital calipers just to see exactly how much space you would have. So I'll just zoom in on that. I make it around 53 or 54 millimeters RAM height you'd get before you're gonna have issues, which means actually things like Corsair, Vengeance, RGB, I've got DDR5, they do fit, but some other sticks like Corsair, Dominator, they will not fit. So it's worth knowing that for sure. But in general, yeah, I think you are going to be having issues, even though this is a mini one and it looks lovely in a mini ITX build, you are going to have issues with clearance just about. So you might want to go for, like, you know, one of the G-Skill ones that tend to have lower clearance and things like that. That's just my opinion though. But actually that is the unboxing for this particular CPU cooler. It's all white. I think it looks really, really nice as well. Like, I'm really impressed with it. And even the fan as well, you know, there's no sign of anything other than white on it, other than obviously the metal bracket, but everything else is white. It's not even like you've got cream rubber, it's white as well, and it feels quite nice and looks quite nice. So I hope you enjoyed this unboxing of this particular CPU cooler. As I mentioned, this is an unboxing, it's not a full review with performance data and things like that, but I'm happy to do that in a separate video if you wanted that, so please drop me a comment if you did want that. And other than that, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button, and please subscribe to see more short videos like this. Thanks for watching.